what to see, what to stream, and what to skip. It's Movie Reviews with Ryan J.
And we are back with a special guy who reminds us it's Friday, and he's also the nationally syndicated film critic, Ryan J.
Yeah, good to see you.
I bring Friday with me.
It's true. Yeah. It only happens when you're here.
Yeah, exactly.
It's true. When you're gone, there's no Friday.
I love that. I'm going to be Friday for Halloween this year.
You could be a good Friday, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you want to play our game where we plug in your birthday and our movie website?
Yeah. What website is this?
Okay, so... I forgot it. I gave it to our producers. It's kind of long. I'll put it on our website. Okay. I'm sorry that I don't have it off the top of my
head. We'll put it on our Facebook page.
But our producers know the movie that was most popular the day that Ryan J.
We
was
don't
born,
know.
But we don't know. So hopefully we recognize it. We'll see if you recognize it too.
What year was it?
1974. The Shining? No. Exorcist?
No way!
It's The Exorcist. That's cray cray.
Whoa.
But it explains a lot, doesn't it?
Oh my. I can't even watch that without freaking out.
I love the movie The Exorcist.
Oh, I can't believe this movie was it.
It must have opened in 73, but then was still probably number one in 74, because I don't think much came out the month of my birth in 1974. Oh. But my favorite movie from 74 is Young Frankenstein.
Oh. Wow. See, you're impressing me. You do know your stuff.
Well, it's my field.
Yeah.
I should know my stuff when it comes to movies.
What movie was number one in 1983?
Yeah.
Just kidding, I don't know.
Yeah. That might have been a good guess, yeah.
All right, here's the first movie you're reviewing for us today. It's rated PG, and is it Black Klansman?
Yes.
Is that it?
Okay. Yes, this is a new Spike Lee joint, and it's one of those truth stranger than fiction movies. It's absolutely unbelievable. It takes place in 1979 about an African-American detective who infiltrates the KKK.
Wow. Whoa. Okay, yeah, so Spike powerful. Lee, you said, is the director.
Yeah, and he's an auteur. You know, so much of what he's done is so powerful, but I feel like Black Klansman is among his best, maybe his best film ever. It really feels one of the first, you walk out of this movie and you're like, that should get a Best Picture nomination, because every detail is so good, from the design to the period to just everything about it. But
he's been getting a lot of attention lately. I saw him on the Today Show. I saw him on a number of different other shows. What about the cast here?
It's incredible. Right there, we're seeing John David Washington, who's outstanding. And then, as an African-American detective, when he's on the phone infiltrating the KKK, but then he has to show up and meet the guys, he obviously can't go himself.
Right.
So he has a white colleague who goes in his place, who's portrayed by Adam Driver, from HBO's Girls and from Star Wars.
Okay.
And he is, he plays a Jewish detective. So it's like both of them, the whole movie, you're like, oh God, just please don't get murdered.
Oh. Yeah.
Because you imagine, black, Jewish, it's like, this is KKK's equal opportunity there, right?
Yeah.
It's very, very intense and stressful and like poignantly dramatic and incredible that way.
You think the themes and the message is timeless?
It is. Well, timely in the sense that, the theme of racism is, has been around, and obviously we evolve as a species and we become woke and enlightened and the rest of it, but it still exists in one way or another. And Spike Lee really does something so cinematically powerful with this film that you have to see to feel it, and it hits you right in the gut. It has one of the greatest endings I've ever seen in film.
Wow.
See it on the big screen. I could easily sit through this movie again. It's just a great film.
See it.
Okay, really quick, is it hard to follow? Can you follow what's happening?
Very
it's pretty easy.
Yes.
Okay.
Great.
All right.
All right, next one, The Meg, PG-13.
And it's a little bit late for Shark Week, isn't it? In July.
Yes,
so
it
I
is.
So I cannot understand why The Meg is coming out now.
Maybe they didn't want to compete.
Right?
Yeah.
They should have struck while the iron was hot there.
Yeah.
But the Megalodon, which is this, larger than big shark, 25 feet plus long, and has some effects and not much on story.
Oh, and I love shark movies. Yeah. Is it all about the marketing with this? I feel like, remember Sharknado?
Yeah.
Yes.
There was a problem with the marketing with this film, because they market it as though, and your people are walking in expecting Sharknado and thinking that it's going to be fun and campy, and Rainn Wilson is in it, and he is tonally accurate in this film, but the rest of the movie misses the boat, pun intended. And it's very, it takes itself way too seriously.
Bad writing.
Jason Statham, very bad writing. The characters are very one-dimensional. There's no connection there. The only thing that really upset me in this movie was there's a little Yorkie who falls off the boat.
Oh.
And I just, at that point, I was like, I'm done.
Was that a spoiler?
I have a Yorkie. I don't care.
Yeah.
This movie, I don't even care. It doesn't matter. It's like,
skip it.
Don't even waste
your
time.
If Ryan's saying skipping,
even if you love sharks?
Yes, even if you love sharks.
I love megalodons. All right.
McQueen, rated R.
McQueen is a new documentary that is based on Alexander McQueen, fashion's bad boy. Yeah. He was an icon. His designs were outrageous and fascinating and disturbing. And, you know, he brought things on the runway that you'd never seen before. And this documentary is fabulous.
Does it accurately kind of go through his resume and show you
it
things?
It does. It kind of follows the points story-wise with his resume. And you see how he evolved in his life and his career with his relationships. And he became, you know, he ran Givenchy and then Gucci and launched his own label. And just the work that he did and the passion and the talent that he brought to this was absolutely unparalleled in the span of like 20 years. Incredible. Mm.
Really quick, I just want to do a correction because Black Klansman is actually rated R, not PG. Is
Thank
that
you.
Correct?
Yes.
Okay. Just want to make sure that I said that wrong. It's rated R.
That's my bad.
Not PG. Mm-hmm. Okay. You have a giveaway.
I do have a giveaway. Well, first of all, McQueen is a See It.
Yeah.
So good.
Sorry.
See It.
Sorry about that.
Skills.
Yeah. Okay. But I do have a giveaway, and because new on Blu-ray and DVD this week, it was out on digital last week, is Avengers Infinity War. You may have heard of it.
Nice.
So it has some great extras on the Blu-ray and DVD, but I'm giving away free HD digital copies at my website.
Woohoo!
Sweet.
So what you got to do is enter at RyanJReviews.com. That's how you can win a free HD digital copy. Good stuff. Thanks, Ryan.
Thank you, too.
And you can like Ryan on Facebook, follow him on Instagram and Twitter. Full movie reviews are on that same website. It's RyanJReviews.com. Awesome job, as always.
Thank you so much.